that every inch is a fight. Robin Black, happy to be with you here at the Sport Accord World Combat Games with Rich Tahoe, former Pancration World Champion, referee, judge, and here my broadcast partner for the men's freestyle, Russia versus the world team. Russia is ahead 2-0, best of 7.
Great to be here with you, Robin. This is awesome.
Yeah, I'm having a good time, man.
Thanks for having me out, man. Oh,
thanks for being here. We're seeing some really good matches, eh?
These are tough. These are great matches.
I'm a Canadian, so sometimes I end a question with A.
Hey? I know, well, I spent a couple weeks with you guys.
Ilyas Burkbulatov. Burkbulatov against Mustafayev of the world team.
You're announcing those names pretty good, much better than me.
Burkbulatov now trying to initiate early for Russia. The Russian team in the red.
Great defense by the world team right there. Russia took a nice shot. World team just spun right out of it.
Mustafayev here for the world team. What will they get here? A warning for inactivity? Passivity?
Nope, just a verbal warning at first.
A reset. Now, if you're the world team and you all are very familiar with how dominant this Russian team is, are you thinking defense in this first period here?
Right now you're looking for position, seeing what your opponent's moving. Little open up in weaknesses. Again, you're coming in. Hand fighting is big at the beginning. Hand fight, heavy hands. Hand fight, heavy hands. It's sounds like I'm repeating, but that's what you're looking for. And then as his head pops up, you're looking for your shots.
And what are some of the subtleties in here with the hand fighting?
Just pummeling inside. You don't want to have your opponent control your head. So you're pummeling back inside, getting them off your head, and then looking to be counteractive with that and do the same thing.
See, the Russian takes the wrist and tries to put that in. Will that give him access to the back, or is that a distraction?
No, just getting him off his head. Yeah. I mean, you're just looking, looking for a two-on-one, especially these guys. These guys are good two-on-one opponents. Technique with that.
Two hands on one arm, on one wrist.
Yeah, and they actually call it a Russian tie, but. Yeah.
The Russian coach not super happy.
No, that was a nice shot. Yeah. Took an inside single leg and just.
We put pressure, hyperextended the knee.
Yeah.
So that's the hand on the back of the on the back of the heel and a bit of shoulder against the knee to hyperextend it.
Yeah, actually came in as initially as a high crotch, and the world team member nice sprawl. Mm-hmm. But he went in on that, and I'm not sure why they blew the whistle, but still 0-0.
Yeah. This is the 66-kilogram matchup between Burkbulatov from Russia and Mustafayev from the world team. 30 seconds left in the first period, still 0-0. Russia ahead 2-0 in this men's team freestyle.
Yep, called the Russian for stalling, gave him 30 seconds to score. What that means is after the whistle blows, the Russian had 30 seconds to score on his opponent. If not, world team member gets that point, and that's exactly what happened. He could not get that score, so now the score's 1-0, is right.
Just imagine when you're looking at this, the amount of work, the back of the neck and the lower back. Oh, gets in just at the 3-minute mark.
Yep, same thing, high crotch.
All that pulling down on the back of the head, that bent over a strong stance. You imagine just the amount of wear and tear on the upper neck and the lower back here. These are young, strong guys, but what kind of life expectancy, I mean, athletic life expectancy, of course, how long can you do this?
I mean, average, wrestler at this level, which is called the senior level, you're probably looking at 26, 27. These guys, I know that the Russians, I'm not sure what age it is, but they usually retire, or actually make them retire after a certain age.
Wow. So even if you're on top of your game, whatever that age is, 27, 28, almost exclusively, that's when you'll put an end to that stage of your career.
They bring in a new member, new team, and they groom them right to be at that weight class.
Wow. Russia has been so dominant throughout all the martial arts here at the Games. Their medal count is, you know, more than many of the other teams combined, even the top teams. Their programs, their athletic programs, and the amount of commitment they have to athletics here is just huge.
Oh, yeah. you know, spent some time with one of the guys that has a actually has two gyms in Moscow, outside of Moscow region. But you know, these guys train five days a week consistently, and the membership, he's telling me that they have you know, well over 200 members. Wow. In their gym, from jiu-jitsu to grappling to pancration. Just crazy numbers.
He's in on that single again.
Yep, there it is. Tables that leg outside, comes up.
That's the second leg.
There's he's gonna offer him a takedown or 1 point step out.
Either way, it's a point. Yep. Russia goes up 2-0.
Gave him a point.
Berkbulatov gets to the back and forces out Mustafiev. Goes up 2-0.
Yeah, push out. Didn't give him the takedown. Gave him the push out.
We're at almost, man, 6, 12, 15, almost 16 minutes of combat here. And you haven't seen these Russians really take a step back. It's been all offense through three different competitors here.
Forward pressure. Forward pressure in the States, you'll see teams like Iowa hit a lot of that. Iowa's very, very heavy-handed forward pressure. A Russian shot in, got his head caught on the outside. World team member takes it, but right now you're just looking at a great defense.
Wow.
There he goes again.
Force out?
Yep. No. He didn't have control, so there was actually nothing. Both guys were pretty even on that.
So he gets to the back. Look at this Russian defense. Sits back with the leg, reaches around, turns his body.
Yeah, just see that, man. These guys are just heavy. They're coming in, working position, you know.
Is this heavy-handed?
Elbow pass, heavy hands. Yeah, this is another, just in a clinch right now, moving them around.
Yeah, you've been in this sport for a lot of years. What are some of the areas we've seen it change into the very modern era? Is some of this aggressiveness? Is it the heavy-handedness? What kind of things we've seen over the last decade?
Changes in wrestling? Not that much. I mean, you'll see a little bit more at the at the collegiate level in the States, you know, a little more fluid. But for the most part, I mean, you just see that constant pressure, and the guys that have that constant pressure will usually wear that opponent down unless you're in great shape. I mean, you just have to be able to move out of the way, move your opponent, and be with them the whole time.
And that's been the Russian game here today through three matches.
They are tough, man. They just keep coming at you. You know, pummel inside, guy comes in, he pummels right back inside. Takes a few steps forward, hands down. Good down blocking.
Mustafiev is just, there's no quit in these guys. At this stage, it takes so much to get to this level in their lifetime. So Mustafiev just not quitting, but man, it's just so much pressure from Berkbulatov.
Absolutely, tried a couple fake shots, but you know, that's not gonna get it. There it is, big win for Russia, 4-0.
So now we have three matches, three dominant Russian wins. And Russia is one match away from clinching this gold medal. Yep. Berkbulatov with a big win here, dominant win.
This will be a really good match right now.
Sargush of Russia.
Sargush is, you know, just an amazing wrestler, bronze medalist at the London Games, two-time gold medal world champion, European champion, three-time European champion.